Today in the Roddy's Kitchen, we are going to make Swedish style meatballs with gravy. Let's get to it. Okay, so we have our 1 pound of ground chuck roast. Check out our ground beef video, link in the description. We have nutmeg, onion powder, and butter. What we're gonna do, salt and pepper also. We're gonna season up our ground, and then we're gonna roll it up into meatballs and saute it. Salt and pepper to taste. Don't you get too exploratory there, miss. As you see, just roll them up. If you've never rolled up meatballs before, you just want to squish it up. Again, just like sausage, you're trying to get a little bit of proteins coming to the surface while you're mixing it up. Helps it bind together. You want these a little bit smaller than a regular Italian meatball you would use for like sauce or something. This is going to be a Swedish style, so you want them a little bit smaller. We're going to throw in our butter. The nice thing about induction cookers, you can move them around. Okay, everybody into the pool. We're gonna let these get a good sear on them. Okay, that's browned up pretty good. What we're gonna go ahead and do is extract our meatballs and throw them back in our cleaned bowl.
Hello friends, Loretta here, aka the mama, making a quick interruption to invite you to visit our Etsy shop, where we have a few different pens, and to let you know we also do custom orders. Now let's go back to the recipe.
Then we're going to take our pan and we're going to pour all this excess beef fat and what's left of the butter in a separate bowl so it can cool down. Now we're going to go in with our heavy cream. Going to drop that down to medium. What we're going to do is the heavy cream is going to simmer and reduce. Going to go in about 2 tablespoons, tablespoon and a half, Worcestershire, whatever you like. Beef bouillon. Now I like this better than Bouillon Brand. I'm going to put about a tablespoon in here, just to beef it up. And then we're going to grab a little mustard. Let's go about a half a tablespoon. This is really better with a Dijon or stone ground or brown, not so much the vinegary, heavy vinegary yellow. If you have any font stuck on the bottom of the pan from the meatballs, you can scrape that up. Makes for good sauce. Okay, I've got a few tablespoons of butter here, and depending on how I think this looks, we're going to add probably a couple tablespoons. Go back up to medium high because we want to get it simmering. Okay, now that's good and mixed together and simmering away, we're going to go ahead and add our meatballs back in. check our with our instant read thermometer. .133 ground beef, you want to go to .160. Even though you grind it yourself, you never know what's on the surface of the meat. And since we ground it, you could have ground that bacteria in, so you just want to cook it properly anyways, which means .160. And we want this sauce to simmer. It'll thicken up as it simmers, which is the great thing about heavy cream. You don't have to use flour or any of the other starches that to use it as a thickener. You can just let the heavy cream simmer down and it thickens naturally. And it has no sugar in it like milk. So depending on the size of your pan and the size of your burner element, you can see sometimes how this focuses the heat in a certain area. That's why you want to keep stirring it. And just make sure you're not sticking. Okay, that's pretty good. You see how it's sticking on the back of the spatula. It's nice, creamy. Let's go ahead and turn this off. And we're ready to serve. You can throw them back in a big bowl if you want to do family style. I typically go straight to the plate. Take our nice little bowl here, do a few meatballs, a little bit of sauce. Okay, maybe a lot of sauce. Sauce is yummy. Meatballs are good, but the sauce is really good. All right, there you have it. Swedish style meatballs and sauce. Have a good one. By the way, don't forget, like, share, subscribe, and leave some comments.